I don't think I have a joke to start off this review.
We're taking over the game one step at a time. Everybody has these dreams of being first in line. It may take a little while before we reach the light. We just gotta take what we gotta make sure.
Burden is the directorial debut from Andrew Heckler and stars Garrett Hedlund, Forest Whitaker, and oddly enough, Usher, and tells the true life story of Mike Burden, an orphan raised within the Ku Klux Klan who finally decides to leave that life when the woman he falls in love with urges him to live a better life together with her and her son, with getting the help from a black pastor played by Forest Whitaker. I was really looking forward to seeing this movie because these are the type of redemption stories I like to watch, whether it's somebody who's involved with a gang and decides to leave that life, or when it has to do with a racist white person who finally decides that racism is insanely wrong. We've seen that movies before, like American History X, Gran Torino, and most recently Skin, which is very similar to this movie. If you guys have not seen Skin, highly recommend you watch it. It's pretty brutal, but that's kind of the reason why it needs to be watched. I really loved this movie. This is such a beautiful film, but not for the reasons you may think, because there are a lot of scenes in this movie, like we would come to expect, that are very difficult to watch, that can make a person mad while watching and maybe wanting to turn off the TV midway. I completely understand that, but this is a very eerily timely film that I feel like everybody should watch. And that has to do with a fantastic performance from Garrett Hedlund. His mannerisms, the way he walks and the way he twitches and sometimes slurs his words, really just gives off an impression to the audience and makes you realize how broken this guy is. We learn later in the movie that he didn't really necessarily live the best childhood. There's one specific scene in this movie that Garrett Hedlund has where he talks about a story that happened when he was young, when he went hunting with his dad, which blew my mind, the way he told it and the way he was kind of moving his neck around. And you guys gotta see the scene for yourself. It's crazy.
That's what my daddy taught me. One time we was hunting, I must have just been about Franklin's age. I was out in the woods, all alone. This deer come right up to me. And I was thinking how cute this little thing was. Like old Bambi and all that other shit, you know. I knew in that moment that he knew something about me. That he could sense something about me. And I knew we was gonna be friends. And he knew it. And all of a sudden, just bam, my daddy blows its head right fucking off. And he called me a pussy when I cried. I realize them, that's the worst thing you could do for them. Make friends with them. As they get comfortable with you, they're just gonna end up getting killed.
So just by looking into his eyes, you can also see just how broken this guy is, in a sense where there was nobody really to put him back together. Nobody who was willing to put his pieces back together. The Ku Klux Klan may have been able to hide those cracks, but deep down, those cracks were still there. And Garrett Hedlund, like I said, pulls all the strings with this. And what I really like about his character is that he's not perfect. He is flawed. There are some scenes where at first you kind of go, oh, okay, maybe this guy isn't so bad. And then later on, something happens and you go, oh, okay, that's despicable. Like, you understand that he's still within this group, but it almost kind of just seems like we're trying to humanize him. And that's another problem that a lot of people were saying they didn't like about this movie. People were saying that the movie was trying to humanize Ku Klux Klan members, specifically the ones surrounding our main character, Mike, when that kind of made me a little annoyed and made me think they didn't even see the movie at all, because that is not the case. The way the Ku Klux Klan is portrayed in this movie is the way you would see them in documentaries or on TV shows or just history books. They are portrayed as monsters because That's what the Ku Klux Klan is. They're horrible human beings. I wouldn't even consider them human beings. Forrest Whitaker, like I said, is also in this movie. He plays as Pastor Dave Kennedy, and he's also trying to do this whole campaign to tear down the Ku Klux Klan Museum, which is the museum that they build at the beginning of the movie. We see in the beginning that they're destroying an old movie theater in this small town, and they're redoing it and modeling it to be a redneck Ku Klux Klan Museum, which I find very interesting and really surprises me that the person who probably sold them this building didn't ask them what they were doing or what, like, it just kind of made me go, how were they able to accomplish that? I haven't done too much research about it, but it was just seemed really odd to me. So that's why I was kind of like, I don't know how they were able to do that. I mean, necessarily this whole Ku Klux Klan, you know, the racism thing, sadly is not illegal. And that's just kind of a shame, but it's just such a despicable thing that we still live in this world where racism still exists. I have friends of many races, Black, Mexican, Asian, and I just don't understand racism. It just doesn't make any sense to me, and it just doesn't make sense why it's still going on to this day. It's despicable, and this is why America is kind of going down. This movie just really infuriates you, but you want to see Mike break out of that life. And one scene, well, actually one little detail that really got to me, which I didn't think about when I first saw the movie until I saw it for a second time, is that when Mike meets the woman who would turn out to be his girlfriend, she has a son who is friends with a Black kid, and the Black kid is the son of Usher's character. And we learn early in the movie that Usher and Garrett Hedlund's character, Mike, were best friends when they were kids. So Mike, in a way, sees that little kid in him and the way how he was with Usher's character back then, and doesn't want him to fall into that life. Because there's another scene where we see Mike Burton's girlfriend's character's son, that was a lot to say, he's hanging out with the Ku Klux Klan members, stabbing tires, doing things that maybe the Ku Klux Klan were having kids do to join that life. And it's just sickening, and it shows how manipulative these motherfuckers are. And it's insane. It's crazy. And it blew my mind. And I was like, wow, that's deep. I'd say my only real flaw with the movie, because I was really struggling to find a flaw, because when it comes to these true story movies, it's hard to find flaws, especially when it's a true story, because you people could argue, well, it's a true story. That's how it happened. Or that's how they met. That's what they did. There has to do with the way Mike meets his girlfriend in the movie. I feel like the setup to that was rather weak. And it kind of just follows the whole formula of she's a single mom, her husband at the time, her boyfriend, was kind of a deadbeat and doesn't really care for the son. She doesn't necessarily work at the best job to pay bills. And I feel the setup to how they meet and how they fell in love, I didn't really buy. And by the end of the movie, I still didn't really buy the relationship. And it just kind of made me go, I don't know about that, but for all I know, that's probably how they did meet. That's just me nitpicking for the most part, and I'd really say, all those little nitpick aside, this is such a very inspiring movie that, like I said, is very hard to watch sometimes, but that's kind of the reason it needs to be watched. I'm gonna give Burden an A-. Guys, thank you so much, as always, for watching my movie reviews. If you guys want to see me review any newer movies or any older movies or maybe a personal favorite of yours, please DM me, or you can follow me on Instagram. I got Facebook, Snapchat, or comment it on this video, and I will gladly do that. And like I said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time with a new video. Peace.